and you were telling me about the Trunomal. What is this now? In the middle of the meal, we're having ice cream? No, what is this?
So it's like, it's a sherbet. It's thyme, fresh thyme and lemon sherbet.
Oh.
With vodka. Yeah, with vodka and with lemon confit, lemon rind.
Yeah, rind. Yeah.
Rind.
Which is
confit.
What we have here
yeah.
on the top.
So we have that between the soup, the main course, and they say it cleans the palate. So
yes.
So then you feel fresh and then you can eat your main course and eat more bread. And
L'amour bouche, is that not, that's something else, isn't it?
So
I guess
it's very
it is,
good.
Yeah. All right, okay, let me, here we go again. See, you're just spending your life watching me eat. I'm sorry, but you seem to like it. All right, this is the Trunomal. Mm.
So it's fresh and at the same time it's like
it gives you
a little
kick. Now you were saying fresh, about how important it is that you make all this
mm-hmm.
here. Do you make the ice cream, the sorbet?
No, sometimes we do. Often we do, but that one we buy it at the Bilboquet, which is a very, very famous place in Montreal, and they do their own gelato, their own ice cream.
This
and
is
they,
incredible, mm. ladies and gentlemen.
I have a bite.
The owner is actually eating lunch with us. This has never happened before, but... And you love your food so much.
I do.
You eat it every day.
Yeah, each time I'm like, oh, wow, it's good.
And then you go home and you have two kids, I think?
Yeah, I have two boys. And then I cook.
And then you cook?
Yeah.
The perfect wife. She makes all this money, runs this restaurant, goes home and cooks, too. So this is a palate cleanser, the famous French palate cleanser mm-hmm. between the two. It's cleansing my palate, I'll tell you. This has got a real kick to it. But the fact that you make everything so fresh makes this restaurant kind of unique. So it's not...
Yeah. Well, it's like that for a lot of French restaurants and other restaurants. But I think fresher it is, better it is. And we try to encourage the people who like them, the Bilboquet, we buy their stuff, and so it's from here, and so everything.
It's the real deal. It's authentic. It's delicious.
Authentic. That's the word.
Yeah,
I think that's
okay.
the word. Yeah.
And now, oh mon dieu, it's the main course or the plat. Plat?
Plat.
I know in America we say this would be the entree, but you say the appetizers are the entree.
Yeah.
And then... the Trunomal, which we just said, and the plat, and guess what? It's the chef who looks like you're still in school.
Yeah,
you just graduated. You're a co-owner. This is Noe. What's your last name?
Lainesse.
Very nice to meet you. I love your restaurant.
Thank you.
So what have we here, monsieur?
It's the shrimp with pastis and simple tomatoes and soya beans. And then you have the duck breast with the lemon thyme sauce and butternut puree. And you got the half smoked salmon, which is half cooked, with the wakame butter.
I keep pointing the microphone at the food like it's going to start talking. The microphone over here by you, I'm sorry. But so tell me a little bit about yourself. You're quite a legend, I understand, as a... chef, and you're so young. Oh, my God.
Well, I opened the restaurant. I was 22, and now I'm...
22?
Now I'm 29.
You are young.
He's a grown-up.
He's a grown-up
yeah.
now.
Yeah, I've grown up with the restaurant. So.
Well, the food is incredible here. And your grand succès.
Thank you.
The other night, it was packed with people who were so happy. Mm. Eating here, and they were all pulling wine out and champagne, and it was fantastic.
Nice, good.
So it's a good ambiance, but it's also first very good food. Yeah, I think that's
very good food.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Okay, I have to try a little, of course. I know this is the first where it's like pointing the food, like the food's gonna start talking.
maybe.
We're in Montreal, anything is possible. So this is the salmon that is very unusual. but
so it's good.
Oh yeah. Yeah, that doesn't taste like any salmon I've ever tasted.
No, it's slightly smoked and it's cooked on only one side.
So
it's half cooked in the middle.
So yeah, in America they say the entree is what you would say is the plot,
mm-hmm.
and the appetizer is the entree. So
I don't know how come. I don't understand.
Well, it probably is from the English, and the English do everything different from the French, so they changed it. So. So you've been here for 7 years too, so you both started this restaurant together.
Yeah. It's working well.
Yeah.
Have you ever been on television before?
Only a bit.
Only a bit. Yeah. So. The secret with television is to keep talking.
Yeah, well, I'm not a talker, so.
He's a cook.
That's why I work in the basement.
Work in the basement. I thought you were one of the waiters, but of course you're the owner. So that's great. That's great. I just love this place. So, and I had the shrimps the other night. They were incredible. And, we'll just... Cotton, no, eat this. Merci, monsieur. And I love here, Nadine Tessier, how... the food is so delicious that the water begins to taste like wine.
It's a miracle.
It's a miracle. Yeah, I read about that somewhere, a book somewhere, once upon a time. Now, the pièce de résistance, et enfin, this is the assiette de fromage, which is like, the French just love their cheese.
Yeah, of course. But here in Quebec, more and more we have cheese that are made here.
Oh!
So it's small business who are doing very good cheese. So it's all made with raw milk. So it's very tasty cheese.
And what
This is cerise de terre.
A cherry of the earth?
Yeah,
It's unusual, but anyway, let's move it here so we can see. These are all different cheeses with walnuts.
Yeah.
And so let me tell me what they are, darling.
Okay, we have blue cheese, and it's called Ciel de Charlevoix.
Oh, wow.
This is from a place in Quebec, which is called Charlevoix. Very popular area, very nice. And then we have the Riopelle, which is very creamy cheese. And Riopelle is a famous painter from Quebec. So that's the name of the cheese because of him. And then we have a cheddar, and it's 5 years of age. And then La Sauvagine. Say that.
La Sauvagine.
Perfect. So another creamy cheese. Yeah.
And to get a fork here. Try one of the. Of course, I have to try it, don't I? After asking the food to talk earlier. I think I'll go for the creamy one, which is what again? The Sauvagine?
Yeah.
Oops. I keep going like this, you know, because I'm didn't polite to talk with your mouthful, but. Being here today at the O-Thym, it's like spending a couple of hours in French food heaven. And you were going to tell me that your amazing, I have to say, amazing chef, Noe.
Yeah.
Went to the famous cooking school here, which sort of explains a little bit how he's so far so fast, right?
Well, Noe did the cooking school, which is called ITHQ, and it's here in Montreal.
ITHQ stands for what in French, I guess?
It's Institut d'Hôtellerie du Québec.
Which all you foodies out there will know what that means and how important that school is.
So all the chefs in Montreal, a lot of chefs are studying there, and they're doing... they're doing a good job. Yeah. Good teacher from everywhere, from France and for a lot of country. And the chef that finish their studies, they go in France to study again, and so it's a very good place.
So in a way, I didn't know that French chefs continue to study like throughout their life, as it were.
Maybe not throughout their life, but after this study at the ITHQ, they go to France and they do a stage. They do
apprenticeship. I think is the word.
That's it.
Internship.
That's it. Yeah.
A stage, an étage is a stage. Yeah. So it's a stage of where they're learning or practicing. You know.
But then Noe, when he finished his school, already just after that, we opened the restaurant. So he started working very early.
Yeah. Right away.
Yeah.
Plus vite. And I can't thank Nadine Tessier enough here today in Montreal. On once again, let's repeat. Oh, you probably have a website too.
We do.
Well, we can put that up on the screen. What is it? What is the?
It's O-Thym.com.
Oh, well, that's easy enough.
That's right.
And we're on 1112. Maisonneuve East, is that right?
That's correct.
I've already memorized the address. I can't memorize anything anymore. But it's a must-stop spot for people who love great French food and a great, relaxing, sophisticated ambiance. Très élégante, très distinguée. And merci, merci beaucoup, mademoiselle. Madame, yes, here at O-Thym.
C'est un plaisir, we'll see.
Have a fabulous, or j'ai un fabu?
No.
No? Oh, okay.
What do you want to say?
Fabulous.
Fabuleux.
Anyway.
You're fabulous.
Right? Oh, is that what I said? Now I know. All right, okay, thank you. One, yeah.